Welcome to Windy City Poker Championship. I'm Jason Finn here on location with Ben Ponzio. Welcome back, Ben.
Good to be back at the table with you, Jason. Super excited today. We've got an amazing event, our $3,000 Summer Championship for Windy City Poker.
I'm pretty excited. We're at the Tuscan Gardens in Glenwood, Illinois. I'd never been here before. I know you were here last night for the ladies' event, the Poker Power event. It's basically just due south of downtown Chicago if you've never been to Glenwood, Illinois before. It's a $3,000 buy-in event, and let's talk about the players. There's Craig Cassino, the winningest player of all time on the Heartland Poker Tour and a regular on Windy City Poker Championship.
In the two-seat, we've got Jeff Halcom. We've seen him here a number of times as well. He's had success both at Windy City Poker and out in the poker world.
And no stranger to our table either, just fresh off finishing the salad, Ben, it's Michael Sabia waving to the camera. Can he hear us?
I'm not sure if he can hear us, but in the four-seat, we've got Art Peavy. We've seen him here before. He plays at the Windy City Poker Championship as well.
And in the five-seat, our current short stack, Frank Panazzo, also not a newcomer, but we haven't seen him at the final table as much as some of these other folks, and we'll see what he can do to spin up those 37,000 chips.
And in the sixth-seat, a newcomer to our final table, but a longtime worker here at Windy City Poker Championship, Jim Skinny Otis. We're going to be calling him Skinny all night, as that's his nickname, and I didn't even know what his real name was.
Skinny. We had 12 players who started this event, $3,000 buy-in apiece. Five of them rebought. They were allowed only one rebuy in this tournament. $1,030 was the cost of the rebuy. Top three finishers are going to get paid today, and there's $34,000 in that prize pool.
Our chip leader starting out is Michael Sabia. He's got nearly double anyone else's chip stack, so we'll see if he puts some pressure on everybody. Starting out with a queen 10, and we'll see if he gets aggressive right here. Sure enough, he comes out with a raise to 10,000.
And Art's going to get out of the way.
Frank throws it away, and it's back to Skinny with a shorter stack and an ace. He's going to look him up.
Heads up. Sabia tends to be a little bit aggressive in position. Makes sense. And he flops an open-ended straight draw. Skinny misses. He's still got ace high and technically the best hand. A little less equity than Michael. And Mike bets and takes it down.
Big stack poker show.
Yeah.
Mike Sabia takes down the first pot of tonight's event.
First two.
So here are the payouts. As I mentioned, just three players are going to get paid out unless they arrange some kind of a deal, which we do allow. $17,500 in cash and prizes. It's Illinois charitable gaming laws. $17,500 in cash and prizes for first place finish. $10,000 even for second, and our third place finisher will take home $6,500 in cash and prizes.
So as we start our next hand, we can see the first couple players threw the hands away, and it's on Art with a 9-8 offsuit. He's going to get in and look it up, though, with a call. Frank with the suited ace. We'll see if he's going to make a move here. He moves his whole stack in, but he's not going to be happy because Skinny's right behind him with jacks. Might shove all in right behind him.
Yeah, this could be bad timing. It's a suited ace, and we can see Craig's got an ace in his hand. So he's going to be a little thin, and Skinny says, I can't fold this pocket pair. He goes all in as well.
That should fold out Craig and Art.
Yeah, and Skinny's got Frank covered, so if Jack should hold up,
then Frank would end up our sixth place finisher.
Fold. Yep. Fold. Sab's working that piece of gum pretty good. Interested to see if somebody's going to accumulate some chips.
Ace three.
You can see there from our graphics, Skinny about
those jacks.
A 70% favorite over Frank's ace tray of diamonds. Frank wants to see three or more diamonds on this board. He can go 2-4-5 for a straight, or just a simple ace would outflop the jacks. Whoa. Not too bad.
That actually gives him two sets of outs. The six or the deuce can give Frank a straight. Or the ace, which comes
and
there.
The ace, and now Skinny needs a jack, or he's going to be our new short stack.
And the deuce, Frank hits his hand two different ways. And that's going to leave Skinny as the short stack. Frank's going to double up to 68,000, while Skinny is down to 25,000.
Craig Cassino has five children, Ben. He must have wanted a son, because he had a daughter, and then a daughter, and then a daughter, and then another daughter. And finally, his fifth child is Dominic, his only son. And amongst his five kids, he has 10 grandkids, which he talks about how much he enjoys spending time with them.
You know, I think my parents had the same thing and wanted a daughter, and they got son, and then after the fifth son, they just gave up.
I didn't realize you were one of five also.
And we see Craig made the raise with the ace-six suited. Michael just called with the ace-queen offsuit. A lot of times a player will put in a re-raise with the ace-queen, but Michael doesn't want to get into too big of a pot with Craig because he knows Craig's stack can hurt him.
Which side was going in, that side or this side?
Heads up.
So Craig comes out firing, hoping that Michael missed the flop. Michael's going to let it go. Again, the power of acting first and putting out that bet, putting pressure on your opponent, because Michael knows that he doesn't want to play a big pot with Craig, because if Craig gets a lot of chips, he's a really, really hard player to play against.
So funny, too, because you couldn't shut Frank up earlier. Jeez.
Now here we see Frank coming in with a raise with the ace-five suited. He is still a short stack, and he does need to chip up.
Skinny and Craig both get out of the way. Jeff folds the mumbler. Sabs folds. And Art's got a big hand. He's got a suited ace-queen.
We'll see if he's going to put in a re-raise and just put Frank to the test for it all.
He does. He puts it all in. He's got 75,000 in chips to start this hand. Oh, it's not all in. Forgive me. Looks like a big raise, but he's got some chips behind.
It's enough to put Frank all in, though.
There you go. Frank is thinking it over.
This is a hard spot when you're a short stack like Frank is, because you have committed a lot of chips. And Art is basically saying, well, you got to put it all in. I don't believe you.
I love that poker move of getting all the chips organized when the other guy puts you to a test for all your stack. You get them all stacked up. In case I make this decision, they're going to be ready to go. Suitcase is zipped up, and he does. He whips them in there.
So as you can see, Art's about a 3-1 favorite here. Frank's going to be looking for diamonds or a 5. Or, of course, the low straight.
And we saw a wheel a few minutes ago, the ace, deuce, tray, 4-5 wheel. And this is a 124,000 chip pot. Whichever player takes it is going to be back in a comfortable position. Four of clubs, queen on the flop.
Pretty good flop.
But the gut shot
everybody.
For Frank. So Frank does have a shot here. If he can hit a 3 or running 5s, he can win this pot. Now that 10 makes it a little tougher. He can win with only a 3. Otherwise, Frank is going to be our 6th place finisher. And with the 9 of clubs, that'll do it for Frank Pinazzo. And Art's going to chip up to 143,000.
Frank had a good run today. Came into the final table as the short stack. His favorite hobby is reading. Ben, I have a feeling he's going home. He's going to read himself to sleep tonight. Get a good night of sleep and wake up tomorrow saying, you know what? I did my best. I played a good game of poker today. Going to say it was a bummer. You can see Joel Amshaw up at the top of your screen there. It was a bummer for him to miss the final TV table. He's always a pleasure to watch.
And his hair today was outstanding.
His hair's been on point.
I didn't even have my cards yet. They already know what it is.
Well, we might see some action here because Jeff with the ace-jack suited and Michael with the ace-nine off suit. Jeff's going to be first to act, probably put in another raise. 15,000 again, and we'll see what Michael does behind him. Oh, he lets it go. Interesting.
Yeah, if the seats were reversed, we definitely would have seen some action there.
Art's debating with the queen 6 suited, lets it go. Skinny with the 6-3 suited, has to throw it away, and Craig also has an ace jack. Some big hands here. I got to imagine Craig's going to at least put in a call here.
We might see some fireworks.
And with the ace on the flop, both players, they're pretty much destined to chop.
There's two clubs on this board. Neither player has a club in their hand.
If one of them does fold, they'd lose the pot. But if it gets to showdown, it will be a chop. This queen here gives them both the gut shot. But really, this is a test of wills of can one guy bet the other guy out of the hand.
16,000. All in.
Craig puts a bet. Jeff's going to move all in, and Craig has to think about it. He knows he could be up against a king jack. He could be up against aces up. And the only card that guarantees him the pot in his head is the king, and that could be a chop.
He's also in a little bit too deep to fold here, but he just knows there's not that much of Jeff's range that he's actually beating. A hand like king, queen of clubs, maybe Jeff might make this play with.
Although, if Craig makes the call and they turn the hands over, the two gentlemen will probably laugh it off and both secretly be a little disappointed. Craig looks like he's going to give it up.
You're running roughshod over me all day.
Roughshod. I haven't heard that in a while, but I'm glad I've been doing it.
Whatever it is.
$10, $20, $30, $40, $50, $60, $70.
Craig's trying to count it out and decide if it's worth the investment. Well, we can see his cards and Jeff's cards. He's not sure, and he does let it go. We'll see if Jeff's going to show him anything.
I had you. I can't show you.
He does not, and he says, I can't show you. And that's going to put Jeff up over $120,000.
I didn't know if you had ace king, ace queen, ace 10, or queen 10, but all three of them just barely beat me.
Ace jack.
You had ace jack?
Mm-hmm.
So did I.
Seriously?
Yeah.
I had ace jack of spades.
I had ace jack.
I had ace nine that hand.
Oh. What's that?
I had ace nine.
There were too many hands that could beat me there.
Yeah. Cool.
We'll see what Michael does in the small blind here, if he puts pressure. He just calls.
And Art Peavy is going to check.
So, yeah.
And with the jack 4-2, Art makes two pair and Michael makes middle pair.
That's not me.
Art's going to check. Michael was first to act. Art checked out of turn. But Michael puts out a little bet. We'll see. Art's probably just going to call. See if he can suck him in for more bets. Now that jack actually is going to make Michael feel better about his hand.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's less likely that Art has a jack. And meanwhile, Art is just grinning from ear to ear, but you can't see it because he's got his poker face on.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy.
The question is, will he call here or raise? My guess is he's going to put in a call.
Yeah, and when you're in Sabia's position, you're thinking about what hand does your opponent have that's worth calling here, because it's a fairly dry board.
And now what's interesting is this is a spot where Art's bet, if he raises here, could look like a bluff.
Absolutely. Like a missed flush draw would be really the only draw here. Or maybe, you know, a tray five for a straight since they didn't put any extra chips in pre-flop.
Raise to 36,000.
And if I'm Michael, I'm making the same bets he's making. Art raised, Michael called.
Whoa.
Art flipped over the quads.
Mike, the response is there. Sorry, no good.
And he paired the deuce.
You got a boat? No good.
I still don't know why they invited me here.
Spectator.
You earned your way here.
You did.
Craig first to act. He folds Jeff. 10-8 unsuited, he'll fold. Michael's on the button. He's got king high. Let's see how he reacts after losing a pretty good-sized pot. Still has 221,000 in chips.
He's keeping up his pressure, knowing Skinny's playing really tight, although Skinny wakes up with jacks for the second time. Hopefully they don't mess with him like they did last time.
And you'll notice that Michael made a min raise to 8,000. Our calls.
My luggage here,
Skinny
right?
is, of course, going to go all in for 19,000.
He's probably going to get two callers. But in this case, two callers is okay because they both have the same card to beat him.
Yeah, it's a great spot to be in with pocket jacks.
And it's little enough money that both players should call. Unless Michael or Art gets crazy and decides to put in a raise.
I call.
And Art's going to let it go. So we're going to see the hands on their backs and watch the card jacks again.
Oh, he folded his hand. Wow, Michael Sabia. Running on four-leaf clovers here.
10, 6, 4, so Michael does catch a piece of it.
That gives him two more outs. Now he can win with a king or a four.
Ooh.
Actually, one of the other kings is dead, which one of the other players must have mucked it pre-flop, so just three outs left.
And the ace on the end, Skinny's going to more than double up. Get back up to 60,000, which is almost what he started the final table
with. I'm saying jacks have held all day.
No, not my first hand here. I lost on jacks.
Oh. Jacks have almost held all day.
De-stacked me.
We've got five left here. If you're just tuning in at the Tuscan Gardens in Glenwood, Illinois, it's the $3,000 buy-in summer championship event on Windy City Poker Championship. Top player gunning for $17,500 in cash and prizes, which is just over half of the prize pool we have here today, $34,000.
Raise to 18,000.
Jeff puts in a raise with king nine under the gun, and he makes it 18,000 to go.
Michael with the quick fold, and it's on Art with the 7-6 suited. A lot of players like to play those type of hands, although to a early position raise, it's a pretty easy fold. Jeff's not going to be happy, though, because Craig with the queens is going to think for a minute and then put out some kind of raise.
And it's an interesting spot because of the size of the raise. Oh, he just makes the call. Wants to control the size of the pot.
Jack, jack, five, but two hearts gives Jeff a flush draw.
Yeah, I think the money is all going in here, Ben, if I had to predict the future.
20,000?
We'll see, though, because with the two jacks, Craig's got to be careful. He might not want to put it all in. He might just check call his way down here. Or he's going to count out a raise.
Raise?
I'm all in.
And Jeff comes right back all in. Now we'll see what Craig decides to do. Craig does call. So we see pocket queens against the king nine. So Jeff needs a heart or a king.
And it's going to be a nice big pot here, 193,000 in chips. Jeff is the player that's all in. If he wins, or 232,000 in chips, forgive me. So Craig will become our chip leader if the queens hold up. Otherwise, Jeff's going to take down a big pot of 232,000, and Craig will be on the short stack.
That's for
sure.
And that four doesn't change anything, but the percentages change. Because now there's only one chance for Jeff to hit his card.
Jeff needs a king or a heart. Ten of clubs doesn't do it.
Nice playing with you as always,
and
Jeff.
Craig is going to nearly double up. He's going to eliminate Jeff Holcomb in fifth place. And we're down to our final four players.
We are now on the bubble. And what that means is one more player is going to go home with nothing. And the remaining three players will be playing for $34,000 in cash and prizes. So at Windy City Poker, you're only allowed to recut it once. So if they make a change here, then the rest of the way they will be playing for the prizes as they stand.
Right, well, it looks like the blinds are 3,000 and 6,000 with 3,000 on the button.
Now, Art with the king nine suited looks like he's going to make some kind of play. I don't know if it'll be a call or a raise. Looks like a call, but skinny right behind with the aces. He's going to put it all in again.
Fellas.
Craig's got one of his favorite hands, the Jack 8 suited, but I don't see him playing that here.
Skinny says, it's okay. One of you can call me. I'm fine with one of you calling me.
So Michael's got ace 8. He lets his hand go as well. And Art's trying to decide if he wants to put in the rest. But Skinny does pick it up.
Yep, Art makes the correct decision. Skinny, once down to 15,000 in chips, now back up to 72,000 in chips. One double up, and everybody is a little bit nervous about what he can do in this event. Also, a shout out to Nick Snacks Activewear, all of the hats, shirts, sweatshirts, and other apparel that the staff here at Windy City Poker Championship are sporting come from Nick Snacks.
Craig has the ace jack of hearts under the gun. We'll see him put in a raise here.
He's gotten some pretty good cards here at the final table. I guess they've all had some good hands already.
Michael throws away his king. Now Art with the ace eight, knowing Craig's aggressive, puts in the call. And Skinny with the king jack decides he's going to call and see it too. So we're going to go three ways to the flop.
Skinny getting a bit of a discount there.
976. Those numbers used to cost a lot of money when you called them.
It also gives Art an open-ended straight draw. I know what you're talking about.
Art puts out 10,000, and the other two players both have two over cards. We'll see if either of them make a call. Skinny lets it go.
And a call.
Craig makes the call. Craig does have the best hand, but Art is playing his draw. Now that queen doesn't really change anything.
10,000.
Art comes out firing again for another 10,000.
I wonder if the bet size gives Craig any information. Craig's been playing with Art all day. It's a pretty small bet, 10 into a pot of 71.
Craig does take advantage of his read and put in a raise.
6,000.
Not because he thinks he has necessarily the best hand, but because he senses that he might be able to get Art off the hand.
See up at the top, Art could win this hand by pairing his eight or by making a straight, because Craig has the best hand but at the moment has no pair.
Art looked at his chips at first. I thought he might even consider a re-raise.
Yeah.
But he makes the call and we'll go to the river. Now Art has to act first, which is part of why Craig was willing to do that. Because now Art has to make a decision, and even though Art paired his eight, that board gets scary.
Check.
And with Art checking, we'll see if Craig comes firing again. And Art's probably going to have to let this go. Even though we can see Art has the best hand, he knows that there's lots of things Craig could have right now that allowed him to put in a raise. And Art does fold.
And this is why Craig's aggression is so successful. A lot of players, they see that 6, 7, 8, 9 on the board. It's 4 across. They've just got ace high. It's possible it's good. It's probably not. And they might check behind there. Craig continues. He says, I don't think he was drawing for his gut shot. I'm going to put this bet in, and I'm going to take it down. And sure enough, he does.
Craig with the 6-2 lets it go. Michael's got a 6-3. He's going to probably let it go as well. But Art wakes up with an ace. See what he does. He puts in a raise. Skinny's got the ace queen of hearts, though. He's probably going to go all in.
Yep, ace seven in the small blind at a four-handed table looks pretty darn good, but not as good as ace queen does to Skinny.
But he may get a call here because it's only going to cost him another 30,000. 36,000.
36,000.
It's a good chunk of Art's stack, but in a four-handed game, that ace seven oftentimes is good. It's a hard spot because you don't know that your opponent has the ace queen, and there's a lot of things they could have that you have beat because you know Skinny has to make a play.
Absolutely. Skinny was going to do this with all kinds of pairs, worse aces, a good king.
So the cards are on their backs. Art did make the call. We're going to see what runs out here. Art needs a seven to eliminate Skinny and get into the money. King 8-5 on the flop doesn't change much. It does give a backdoor flush draw to Skinny, and a backdoor straight draw to Art, but those are both dead on the turn. So now a 7 and only a 7 will eliminate Skinny.
An 8 or a 5 would make it a chop.
And Skinny hits the queen and is going to double up.
Nice hand.
And he is no longer our shortest stack with 103,000 chips. Art is now down to 85,000.
Art having a good week, not only because he made the final table here today, but some other good news in the family. He's got two kids. He's got a 24-year-old, a 26-year-old. The elder is his daughter, and the younger, his son, just went to China, just moved to China to play professional basketball over there. He's a college basketball player, and the proud papa will hopefully get to stream some overseas games.
And his son might stream some overseas poker.
There you go. Michael with a pocket pair here under the gun makes it 16,000 to go.
Art and Skinny are going to get out of the way. And Craig with the ace king is going to probably put some pressure back on Michael. He does just call. We've seen Craig do this a couple times.
Heads up.
Specifically against Michael. He's been trying to avoid a big pot. Now we've got to flop all spades with the king. So Craig likes his hand, but he's a little worried about the spades. Michael comes out betting. Craig's worried that if another spade comes, it could be a problem, so he may want to put pressure, get Michael out, or make him put it all in for now.
He does indeed. He puts in a raise.
Good hand.
And he shows the king after Michael folds.
46,000, and Michael says, you know, sometimes this game's just not fair. Chip leader adds some more chips to his stack. You can see a couple of our other sponsors there in the background, EOC Audio, Taddy Stick. Taddy Stick is a product that's used for after tattoo care and a great sponsor of our show. You can find them at TaddyStick.com. Find them on TikTok or Instagram under their handle TaddyStick.
Craig makes the call and Michael taps the table with Craig's birthday. And the ace deuce six is going to give Michael the middle pair.
Check.
Craig's got no piece of it. Michael comes out betting after Craig checks. And that's going to win him the pot. Even though Michael's short, people would say, why doesn't Craig put pressure? Craig's being really cautious not to give Michael a chance to accumulate a bunch of chips. He knows how dangerous he can be. Michael's not just dangerous at the table, he's dangerous behind the wheel. One time when we were here, he hit my car in the parking lot.
You know, it's gonna surprise you, Ben, but I've heard that story before.
It tells you how good of a guy he is that I still like him.
I mean, you hit it? Come on. It was... I almost totaled it.
Raised to 50,000. 50,000. Fold.
Sorry, Ben. Were you backing up or something? Backing up or pulling up, I just touched it. He had a brand new black, Cadillac, I don't know.
Kirk just came and told us that Michael apologized for hitting my car to the fans at home.
Has he ever apologized to you directly?
He did.
Okay, all right.
So you can see the chip stacks here. Craig way ahead with 43 big blinds. Everybody else is pretty close with between 12 and 17.
All in.
Now Michael with
all
the pocket in. Tens is going to shove all in.
Fold.
Art lets it go. Skinny wakes up with a bigger pair.
Wow.
And he's shoving in right behind. Craig's kind of happy that he doesn't have to decide on that hand. It's an easy fold.
Nice hand.
After three or four hands into the final table, Skinny's been running pretty good. He's played well. He's found his spots. And Michael's been running into all kinds of stuff. Just been unfortunate.
Yeah, Michael's been playing well. He definitely doesn't deserve to have lost all his chips.
A7 deuce. Neither player improves. Both players have a diamond, so that's not going to come into play.
Well, that queen just ended the hand. Michael Sabia is going to be our fourth place finisher. The six on the end doesn't mean anything. And a great game played by a guy who we've seen win this tournament three times and cash many times.
Thank you.
Skinny that came from nowhere.
Now, as the field gets shorter, you're going to see players play a little more aggressively, play more hands. Craig with the ace nine here would have raised even with more players in the small blind.
Raise it.
And Art likely to throw away the 9-6.
Sad part about it, I know you don't have anything.
Would I do that to you?
Yes, you would.
Art accuses Craig of bullying him, and Craig shows the hand just to show that he wasn't bullying this time.
Yeah, 9-4s are tough.
9-6.
Fold.
Skinny folds. Craig with the queen 10 is going to get in the hand. He just calls, and Art with the jack nine is going to put in a raise.
28.
We'll see if Craig decides to mix it up with him. Looks like he's gonna.
Call. Heads up to the flop.
So both players have similar hands, and a flop like this, you can see Craig flops the two-way straight draw, and Art flops the middle pair with the jacks. So Craig can win with a nine, a king, or if he pairs his queen.
And that wasn't what he wanted to happen. He didn't want to get stuck by putting in a bet and then being forced to call. But he checked, and now Art has gone all in for a full pot-sized bet.
Yeah, with the size of the pot, if Craig knew what Art had, he might make the call. But he really just lets it go, conserve the stack, wait for a better spot to take the other players out.
To three-handed here at the Tuscan Gardens in Glenwood, Illinois. They've been a great host for us this weekend. I know you were here yesterday with the Poker Power folks and the women's event, a great event last night that you live streamed. I was not able to join you. Happy to be here with you tonight. Had a great salad earlier, by the way. Salad, Caesar salad with chicken. They've got a great menu here, all kinds of stuff. I don't know if you had a chance to have a bite.
I did. I had something yesterday and something today. Everything so far has been really good. The servers have been nice and friendly. The food's been good.
The poker games all weekend. I've seen they've done some auto enthusiast events here and some other cool things at the Tuscan Gardens in Glenwood. So thank you to those folks for hosting us this weekend.
Now, you mentioned the ladies' event yesterday. A little bit about Poker Power, the organization we partnered with. Poker Power is an amazing organization that teaches women the skills used at the poker table, how to play poker, anyone from high school students to business professionals, but then they teach you how to take those skills, apply them in the business world and in life. It's an amazing organization. The event we had yesterday was so much fun. We had a bunch of women out here, some who had never played before, some who had been playing for a long time, and we even had people whose first tournament it was make the final table.
We sure did. I saw Melissa McGurran from
US 99.
US 99, thank you. I was blanking there for a moment. Make the final table. And she had a lot of people, some of the folks we spoke to today talked about how she had them on the ropes. They had no idea when she was bluffing, when she had the best of it. And she played a good game. I know that you've known her for a really long time. AJ Rudolph also finishing the event in third place. And AJ, a representative, a spokesperson, an instructor, at Poker Power, a really awesome advocate for the game and an awesome human being.
Some of it's very jokey.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. Some of it's
hard to tell.
His skinny's got an ace in the small blind. He's going to probably put a raise in here. He's not going to be happy because Craig right behind him has a bigger ace. So we've got ace eight from skinny.
What was that?
Ace queen from Craig.
23K.
Makes it 23,000, and we'll see what Craig does here. If he's going to put a big raise in or just call. We've seen him typically call in these situations today.
I can afford that.
And he does again with the coquettish, I can afford that. And 9-7 deuce, neither player's hand improves.
I think I might have got a piece of this one. Hold on, let me check here. 10K.
How much?
10.
How big a piece?
It's a pretty nice piece.
Raise. It's like 32.
Did you get a better piece than I got?
32K.
You can be honest with me. You get a better piece than me on that one?
It's either that or I'm bluffing. It's one of the two.
I know that.
You know me.
That's why it's very treacherous to be at a poker game with him, with you, sir. You're the best. The rest of us are just imposters.
Nah, I don't think so.
Well, I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to throw that one down regretfully. But I think you had probably a goodie. Yeah. Good hand.
What, you have a seven?
I had a hand. Wasn't as good a hand as that one. I made the right decision.
And we get a battle of the blinds here. Skinny's gonna put in a raise. And Craig with the 9-7 of hearts, this is the kind of hands that Craig really knows how to hurt people with, is going to make the call.
I love the 9-7 of hearts, that's a good one. The destroyer.
And 9-8-5 skinny picks up the flush draw, while Craig has a pair and a gut shot. We could see a really big pot here.
I think you're right. Skinny's got two over cards and the flush draw.
They do both want to wait out Art if they can. But if they can hurt the other one with a big pot, they will. So Craig's going to put the bet out. Skinny's probably going to make the call.
Call. Looks like a pretty good sized bet, too. 35,000, about half the pot. Gets a call. Quick call from Skinny, by the way.
So we'll see if that slows the action down. Skinny now has the best hand with the pair of tens and comes out firing. Pair of tens and a flush draw against Craig's open-end straight draw and pair of nines.
Yeah, Craig didn't love that one, and that's a big bet. 75,000 chips. That's going to really hurt.
And he knows he's going to have to face another bet on the river. So if he puts it in and doesn't hit, he's going to be in a really tough spot.
Yeah, he counted it out, but I don't think he's going to make the call. He's still got 240,000 chips in his stack.
But this call would take him down to 170 or 160, and then whatever skinny puts out on the end.
Yep.
He does make the call.
Wow. Craig needs a 9 or a 7 or a jack because the 10 gave him an open-ender.
And the 6 gives him the straight.
Yes,
so Craig now has the best hand. Skinny makes the bet. Puts out only 15,000.
A little bit of a blocking bet. Craig looking back to make sure he's made the straight.
Craig's trying to figure out what this bet means. I think he's going to put out a raise.
He's just trying to determine what percentage of Skinny's range is the queen jack. And he decides not much because he does go all in for 166,000. No, Skinny's got a little something, maybe two pair, and can call this all-in bet to minimally catch a bluff.
Skinny's getting a count, but I don't see how Skinny makes the call.
166.
He He is counting out his stack to see where he's at. It's a tough spot because he was ahead on the turn, and he knew Craig was struggling there. It's hard to put Craig on the hand with a seven there.
And right now, Art is saying, please call. I don't care which one of you wins.
Right.
Just please call.
I know what Art's thinking.
Skinny's replaying the hand in his head, trying to figure out what Craig could have. But without something specifically like 9-7,
wow,
puts it in.
He makes the call and not real happy about it, the way he dumped those chips in there.
Hey, it's a good hand. Played well.
Thank you.
All right.
Really sorry.
Hey, no problem. That's the game.
And Craig really did have him covered. Wow, amazing. We will count it down just to make sure. It's done. Wow, wow, wow. Just a moment ago, Skinny with the chip lead with just three players left. Craig close behind him, picked up a couple of chips, took the small edge, and then they played a really combative pot. Art is thrilled. He's, of course, the short stack now by a good margin, but he has made it into second place and heads up. He's got a shot at it.
Time to make an epic comeback.
Yes, sir.
It's going to happen to me. You got me like 10-1.
So Art's at 85,000 chips. Craig has 606,000.
Wow.
But in the game of No Limit Hold'em, if Art wins two pots, he becomes chip leader.
Art's got still more than 20 big blinds, so by no means is he in grave danger unless he finds a spot that he needs to go with. And Craig also has a hand. He's going to be on the button and also first to act. In No Limit Texas Hold'em, the small blind and button are one in the same preflop. He just limps in.
Craig with the queen seven.
Go ahead.
Got too many chips over there.
Yeah, I'm sure you'll make a valiant effort at taking them away.
Jack 9-8 doesn't help anyone. Craig does pick up a gut shot, although he's still behind. He's going to check, and we'll see what Art does here.
Lines up next hand.
If Art wants to gamble, the queen on the turn does give Craig the best hand.
Check.
But it does give Art a gut shot now. And they check, check to the river, and the 10 means Art's going to make the straight. So now we'll see what happens. Craig looks like he's going to cut out a bet.
Yeah, Craig not super thrilled about that 10 coming because there's a straight on the board. And while Craig technically has a straight with his seven, it wouldn't play.
And what Craig's doing here, he's making a bet, knowing that there's a lot of times where the other person doesn't have the straight, and they've got to decide, you know, Art's got a short stack. He's got to decide, does Craig have the king, and do I need to get out of the way? But Art does have the king, so he knows he's going to shove all in. And now Craig's got to decide if Art's doing the same thing to him.
Craig knows that if he calls here at best, he's calling to chop the pot with Art.
And he's getting 3-1 on it, but really he's getting 1-1 because he'd only get half the pot back.
That's right. It's a great spot for Art to do this if he didn't have the straight. And Craig's got to consider that as well.
There's no grandstanding or showboating here because if Craig had the king, it would be an instant call. Art can't act in any way afterwards, so Craig is deciding and decides to correctly let it go. That's a great laydown.
And Art picks up 38,000 chips. His stack is now at 123,000.
I guess I've showed you a few. And
now here we've got Craig has the queen seven computer hand again. back-to-back hands, but this time he's up against a jack four.
What's a jack four?
Checks the option.
I don't know. Busting me?
And that's not a bad flop at all for jack 22. Four. I suspect Art's going to check and let Craig do his bidding.
Craig would literally need two running queens to win this pot. And he comes out betting 22,000 because he knows it's not likely Art has a jack. Unfortunately, he does.
If we ran this situation out, all five cards, 780 times, Ben, Craig would win one of them.
And Art just calls because he wants Craig to continue betting, although I don't know that Craig will continue.
Now he's looking back at his hand. Craig already knows he's done because there's no draw on a jack-jack four board.
Right.
30.
And the deuce isn't going to change anything because it's an undercard to the four.
But if you're Art, you're almost better checking down,
yep,
hoping Craig decides to bluff.
Yeah, well, you had four before, so I figured you probably had three this time.
So Craig shows it to him. And Art's chipping his way back into this game.
He sure is. You know, Art started out in a $10 tournament. He took $10 and parlayed it into this $3,000 event where he is now heads up to, at a minimum, win $10,000, to go from $10 up to $10,000. That's a pretty good result.
Raise.
And look at that. Kirk Fall, our executive producer, the man is everywhere doing everything. Now tell me, did it take that long for Craig to get his coffee that he ordered like 20 minutes ago, or is that a second one?
I don't know. That's a big coffee, too.
It's like it's going down pretty quick.
He's going to have to stop three times on his drive home.
I only point out the duration to delivery because our executive producer, Kirk Fall, as I mentioned a minute ago, doing all sorts of things here.
Button's good.
Hurt's got a good starting hand here. He's got the January 1st birthday, as Craig pointed out earlier.
Art just puts in a small raise. Craig's going to make the call.
And the best was the way he did it. He put the raise in, and he went right back to his coffee. I'm just going to put a little sugar in here, Craig.
Although that's a well-known tell. Although Craig outflops him with two pair.
Well,
it's a well-known tell when you act disinterested in that situation. You're probably pretty strong. Now, some players reverse tell it and all that, but seeing his hand, we know that he's strong. And it goes check, check.
Wow.
And the nine here puts Art back on top.
Amazing. I was going to say this could be the last hand of the tournament, but...
Not anymore.
That nine might be a lifesaver for Art. Craig actually went from best to drawing to four outs.
40. And now he puts in the raise. Although Art's got to worry, could Craig have a 9 or a 7-8 and have slow played it? Art's going to correctly shove all in.
He's not too worried.
Craig's got to say, all I've really got is middle pair. But what could Art have that he just checked the flop after raising preflop?
Can you pull in the 40 and see what's left?
And now Craig's trying to figure out the math here. He's getting 3.5 to 1 on a call. There's 177,000 in the pot. It's 49 back to Craig.
Just 60.
He's not loving it. Art raised preflop.
Art.
That's three arts. That's not a good sign.
No.
What are the odds that I flop two pair and you flop a set?
That's not exactly it, Craig. He calls.
He's going to be disappointed when he sees it.
And Art is
worried about his coffee.
Art's
going to
slow roll him as he gets the sweet and low in there.
So a 6 or a 5, Craig can still win the hand. But otherwise, Art's going to double up.
Wow, it's a huge pot.
This, better be a
this game is not six. Over.
Oh,
except that it is. Oh,
wow.
No.
Sick, man. I am so sorry.
Oh,
Craig
no.
even feels bad That's about horrible. That.
Oh, my goodness.
Art played that hand perfectly.
Well played.
And it just backfired. He had Craig talking to himself, got him to make the call.
He did a great job.
In fact, if you think about it, you play the hand back. Art only put money into the spot when he was ahead. Got the money in on the turn. Just got unlucky. I had already written it off, Ben. And we have a 2022 Windy City Poker Championship Summer Champion. On behalf of Ben Ponzio, the cast and crew of Windy City Poker Championship, he's Ben Ponzio, I'm Jason Finn, and we'll see you next time.